Okay, imagine a rainy day and think about how you're feeling about that. Maybe it reminds you as a cold and gray and sad day, right? But as all we know, that rain has a lot of benefit for us. It can replenish rivers, it can grow plants, and so on. So it actually depends on our perspective that how we feel that something is optimistic or pessimistic. And you know, it's that's what we call it, the cognitive bias. And you know, it's completely fine to feel sad time to time, because in fact, we have some natural reward system in our brain that help us to cope with stress and negative feeling. And one of these reward systems is called opioid system. And if it's impaired, it causes some negative feeling and depression. So let me just tell you some fact about depression. In Europe, for example, 3 out of 4 patients with depression do not respond adequately to their medication. And also it takes time, usually 6 weeks or more, to start to show the benefit of medication. So it's kind of the urgent need to find a fast-acting treatment. And one approach can be to find a measurement of treatment response using optimism. My project has developed an animal model to show optimism or pessimism of tested draw in animal. So in this model, we face the animal with 2 bowls with different materials, including a chocolate as a reward inside. And one of these bowls is only available when the animal is injected with tested drug. And the following day, the animals should just choose one of these bowls during the several trials. And if the animal choose the bowls that pair with the drug more than the other one, it means that the drug causes optimism. Here in the graph, you can see when we inject the stress hormone, if you follow the red line, the animals show kind of the pessimistic view. On the other hand, when we inject the drug, in this case, the opioid-based drug, if you follow the green line, you can see that it blocks the negative feeling and actually stimulates the reward system and show kind of optimistic view. So using this approach, we can establish that which treatment that patient will respond quicker. And you know that the drug that I use in this model that shows the positive effect is currently in development using a patient in clinics. And that's really makes me optimistic about the future of treatment for depression. So, and in the end, I would like to say thank you very much for your optimistic attention. So you should just be optimistic to fight against depression. Thank you.